audience. LoveLine may contain sexually oriented content. Listener discretion is advised.
3, 2, 1, go.
Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
LoveLine, coast to coast.
Hey, it's LoveLine. I'm Adam Carolla. It's Dr. Drew over there. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Fax number 310-854-4455. Dr. Drew, board certified physician, addiction medicine specialist. Yeah, Drew.
Yo, baby. What's happening?
Well, Alien Ant Farm is our guest tonight, and I don't think we've ever met them.
No.
I think they're excited to be on the show, but the show started and they're not here. Now, they are here. They just went off to another room to do an interview or something in the massive Westwood 2 compound we work in here, and I bet they're under the impression someone's going to come get them.
No. The temerity. Can you imagine?
Certainly wasn't going to be one of us.
The Sudis must have impressed them so much. The efficiency with which this place runs must have led them to believe that there was somebody specially dedicated to retrieving them.
Right.
Yes, of course.
All right. Yeah. Drew, you turn into a bigger a-hole than even me. So, we will bring the band in at the first break. And, Drew, everything flowing good for you?
Yeah. How about you?
No problems?
No.
Yeah.
Why?
It's all good.
Good time.
Just working. Yeah, I just realized, you know, listen, kids, as you get older, man, the days just whip by. You know those old movies where the wind kicks the calendar pages?
Yeah. That's what it feels like.
Pow,
wait,
gone.
Adam, wait till you have children.
Oh, no.
It is like climbing into a effing time machine.
No, you know, having kids, it's like giving birth to a little ruler or a little calendar. It's like now you have a way to measure the time.
Yeah.
Remember the first Christmas?
Yeah.
Oh, it's Tommy's birthday.
Yeah.
And then, pow, it's gone. Yeah, you know what's going to happen? Here's why I'm scared to have kids. Because when you have kids, then you become the parents that were so old when you used to play with your little friends.
Listen, tonight with my kids, I had a conversation about the Brady Bunch. And these are all, we've met pretty much all that cast. And to their mind, these people must be 20 now.
Oh,
when I explained them they were in their 40s, they were like, oh, my God. And then, how old is Mrs. Brady? How old is Mr. Brady?
Oh, Mr. Brady.
Yeah, and I said, well, he's gone.
Yeah.
Really? I said, well, how old was he? He died. How old was he? He was probably like 50 or something.
It could have been,
so I said 55, and they went, oh, well, he was old.
That's
he was
right.
Really old. So, okay, so that was all right.
He's sure. Bisexual.
Nice. Yeah. I know. I used to. I remember when I was, you know, 13, 14 years old, and hear about some guy buying it on a motorcycle who was 22, and I thought, we had a good life. We had a good, long, rich life.
Nice long run.
I hope his grandchildren and his great grandchildren were by his side when he slipped away.
All yes. Right. Perspective is everything, isn't it?
All right. Well, listen, I tell you, I look at life as a drive to San Francisco. The first time you made it, it took a long time. If you've done it about 30 times, it don't take that long anymore. And if you've done it several thousand times,
you don't even
think about it. Yeah. That's what a year's like now. Except for this show. Boy, does it stop when we get in this studio. This conversation we've had feels like it's been about 8 years.
Yeah.
It turns out it's been 3 minutes.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah, just about another 117 minutes to go. What do you say, Drew?
Beautiful.
Bill?
Good times.
Yeah, this is Bill.
You're 16. What's up?
I was, like, masturbating earlier today, and I hurt, like, I don't know what happened, but, like, right after I, like, came, I guess, it hurt, like, right underneath my testicles and on, like, the right side of my groin.
Right. It's oftentimes a spasm of the pubococcygeus muscle.
Oh, it's not like a hernia or anything?
No. Certainly hernias and things like that might be triggering all that, so it wouldn't be a bad idea to get yourself checked out. But this kind of thing can be rather common, actually, and it doesn't necessarily mean anything, yeah.
Okay, because it really hurts.
It kind of aches. It's sort of like being kicked in the nuts a little bit.
Yeah, like whenever something touches like my right testicle, it hurts.
That's a little different.
It's like really sore. It's pretty sore underneath them, but like my right one hurts a little bit more than my left.
Well, you ought to get that checked out. Maybe there's a little bit of torsion or something. Sometimes the testicle twists and can impair its blood supply, and it can really hurt itself.
How often do you masturbate?
Like once a day.
Yep, even though it's excruciating pain. That's what I love about guys. All right, Bill. Hey, good times. What should you do? See a doctor?
Yeah, it wouldn't be a bad idea. But how can people even think for a second that men and women are similar? Hey, listen, a woman, if there was the slightest bit of discomfort, no, if it felt good, they still wouldn't well, be that interested.
Yeah, I love it when you talk to women. It's like, have you masturbated before? Once when I was 17, the sensation was exquisite.
But it doesn't do much for me.
I'm 28 now. I haven't done it since. And no mess. And you know what I mean? I did it in the car.
Yeah.
But it was all right. It was good. That was enough.
Think about trying to get a guy to stop.
No way.
No way.
That's all I got now.
No,
I was
you could
my
say,
older age. That's it.
I mean, think about it. Your eyes are going to fall out. It's going to hurt and have intense pain. No way. I mean, there's nothing. Think about it. Is there anything you could do?
If you told me that at the end of 100, I'd have no sight in my right eye, I'd get to about 75, and then I'd start, you know, really start slowing down.
But you wouldn't stop.
I'd think about it more.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Be every other day.
Taylor?
Yeah.
You're 21.
Yes.
What's up?
Okay. I have two younger brothers. One is 7, one is 8. They're 11 months apart. And 2 years ago, we found out that my 7-year-old brother, he was 5 at the time, was being sexually abused by his father.
Uh-oh.
And he had been acting like a girl since he was about 2 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And so everything...
Whatever that means.
Means, like, he would talk in a girl's voice. He would say he would want to be a girl. He would mm-hmm. wear dresses. He would wear towels on his hair, on his head, and pretend that it was long hair.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I mean, you know, the kid wanted to be a girl, and he walked around acting
All right.
like a little girl.
And his biological father was molesting
yes.
him?
Yes.
Yeah.
Nice. This is your right. father?
No, this is not my father.
You right. said it was your brother.
Right.
Half-brother.
Right. We have okay. different fathers.
All right. How's your father? I bet he's a child.
Not around.
Yeah.
Shocking. Right. Shocking.
Right.
Yeah. Kick
exactly.
your mom right in the ovaries next time you see her, please.
Yeah, she hasn't made the best decisions when it comes to men.
Yeah. No. By the way, get her dad and kick him in the nuts.
Yeah, well...
Your mom's dad.
Yeah, I wonder. He died when my mom was 8, but that's interesting. Though my mom was sexually abused as a child.
Yeah, that's
right.
the point.
Who did
I mean,
that?
Her brother.
Oh, her brother.
Right.
Well, someone
know,
got...
All yeah. just amazing, right?
No, it's not amazing. It's,
yeah, exactly.
It's pretty easy math, yeah.
Yeah.
So now what are we going to
okay,
do?
Okay, well, my question is, A, how do we react to my brother? My brother has been in counseling since we found out that he was being sexually abused.
Mm-hmm.
The counselor says it's very likely that he was being sexually abused probably from infancy.
Agreed.
Is he still walking around like Carmen Miranda with that
yes.
towel on his
that.
Head?
All right, what is your question?
My question is, what do we do? My mom, myself, do we encourage this behavior? Do we discourage this
just
behavior?
Just get him therapy. Don't shame him, but just get
yeah.
him therapy.
And then another question is...
You say he's 11 now or 10?
No, he's 7.
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, 11, at 11, he's 11 months older or younger
right.
than the 8-year-old is.
Right.
Right, okay.
Okay, also, if he is gay, I
yeah.
mean...
Yeah.
I've entertained the possibility. Is that simply a product of his dysfunction? And
well,
if so, what do we, you know, like, how do you react to that?
Well, many children, male children that are sexually abused by a male become gay. Now,
right.
is that, was there some biological predisposition there? Those people are sort of rendered that way. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Those that have the biological predisposition, they're sort of born gay, is probably a different population.
Mm-hmm.
And we certainly see the pattern here all the time, is that if it's either a confused or gay male, usually sexually compulsive, has that history. I mean, that's commonly there.
Well, listen, here's the good news for society, Taylor.
Yes.
A, if he was straight, he'd probably stab some guy by the time he was 12 and be in juvie. For a good 14 years and then be busted for dealing crank.
Right.
All right. Now, so as it is, he's just going to start some recycling program and meet himself a nice guy and not populate the planet with more screwed up kids. So in a way, it's nature's way. And it's an interesting thing. And we never talked about this, Drew, but it just popped into my head. It's nature's way of saying, hey, you've screwed this kid up badly. He's not going to have any kids to screw up. It's going to stop here.
Yeah.
He'll be gay, and he won't have any kids.
Well, see, I'd prefer not to label him, though, as this just like...
Oh, call him homo.
That he's going to be an
offender. Oh, I see.
You know what I mean?
Right,
like,
right.
I hate to think
right.
of my 7-year-old brother as...
All right, well, listen, stop thinking about it so much. I mean, he's 7. You got to, yeah. you know, he's got a good 6-7 years before he makes a move.
Right.
So just relax. Yeah, you're 21.
Be supportive. Get him some treatment.
Yeah, what's up with you?
Actually, I'm getting ready to graduate from college, a four-year university.
University.
So, where are you going?
I go to Lewis and Clark College.
Oh, man, I almost went there.
Are you serious?
Well, almost. You count them sending me a letter to play. They sent me a letter to play football there. Yeah.
So I'm getting ready to graduate, and I'm doing the Teach for America program.
Yeah, that's a good school. Little school.
Yeah.
Yeah, nice. All right, baby. Hey, good times. Don't worry about your brother so much.
Stay supportive. Love him.
Right.
Just relax.
He'll be fine.
Okay.
Yeah, he's in therapy. He'll do all right.
All righty.
He'll probably be some great composer or something.
Yeah.
Something very artistic.
Yeah.
He loves to dance.
There you go. Lewis and Clark. Where is that? Well, say
Portland.
That.
Must be Portland.
Portland? Yeah. Yeah, I got a few letters from them. Noah?
Hello?
What's up?
Yeah, I got two questions for Dr. Drew. I was wondering if I could ask one on the air and one off.
Mm-mm. Now, one on the air and none off the air.
All right.
All right. So you want to ask? I'll tell you what. Why don't you ask the off-the-air question on the air and then save the on-the-air question for off-the-air? Mix it up a little bit, huh?
How would you know which one's which? I could be
I'll trust you, Noah.
All right.
All right, go ahead.
I can ask the two questions, please?
Yeah, all right. Go.
Thanks, man. All right. I just started dating this girl like 2 months ago, and we got intimate. And she's kind of big, you know, I'm not going to lie. And when I went down, her inner thighs were kind of discolored. Like, she's white, but they were like, I don't know, like she had beige or brown skin.
Mm-hmm.
I was wondering if that was from friction or...
Yeah, people will pigment where the skin has been irritated. It could be from fungus, yeast.
Was it on her northern side? Because it could be moss.
No, it's from irritation of some type.
Yeah, it was just on her inner thigh. It wasn't real up high, just...
It's from irritation of some type, either yeast or friction.
How'd you fit down there? Did you have to get a running start, or you just tip over on the bed, do that log in the forest thing?
I'm pretty strong. I kind of force the legs open.
Nice. Yeah, that's what I do when I go down on a woman. I get rigid, and I put my hands behind my back, and I just tip over. I pace it out 6 feet from their vagina, and then I just tip over so my face lands right on it. How big a gal is she?
Oh, 180, 190, I'd guess.
Yeah, they need love too, Noah.
What's your other question?
It's like for my sister. She didn't want to call, but what? She has. We listen to the show all the time. And a week or two ago, you had a guy calling about his girlfriend having facial hair.
Yeah.
And that's kind of my sister's problem.
Vanica is the cream.
Thank you.
Vanica.
She didn't want to get on the phone. I was like trying to hand her the phone as we were like in commercial or something like that.
Vanica, I think it is spelled.
And that's, all right, wait, again, one more time?
Vanica or Q-U-A. I'm not sure. I think it's Vanica.
Yeah, because in my opinion, Vanica. You know, she has a husband and don't look that bad, but just like on the bottom of her chin.
Yeah,
and
that's all right.
All, I don't know, women are like that, I guess.
It's for the light skin. It's for the Dr. Seuss, hair. The
Vanica?
Sam I am.
What do? Rub it on?
Yeah.
You get a prescription?
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. If it's over the counter, you'd eat it, but, you know.
You'd die,
eat it by the spoonful.
Of course.
You'd kill yourself.
Yeah.
Right. But you can get it from prescription. Interesting. Mike?
Yeah.
You're 31?
Yes, sir.
What's up?
Well, I got a couple questions for you.
All right.
Me and my wife have been married for 7 years.
Mm-hmm.
And we have a 2-year-old, a 3-year-old, and a 7-year-old.
Uh-oh. Yeah.
And she's on, my 7-year-old is on spring break.
Mm-hmm.
And my question is, okay, she went back up to her family, you know, around the Akron area.
All right. In Ohio?
In Ohio.
Right.
Yeah. She, you know, this is the first time in 7 years that we've been, like, not totally... Me and my wife don't talk.
I see.
She's here. The kids are here. Everything's fine.
Right. Why don't you talk?
Because I guess we don't have nothing to say to each other, I reckon.
All right. Well, I'll buy that. You're all talked out.
Yeah, but what it is she's not here. The kids ain't here. I can't sleep at night.
Right now?
Right now.
Why can't you sleep at night?
Because I'm used to my daughters getting up in the middle of the night, you know, just to carry on. And
what do you mean, carry on?
You know, cry, you know, daddy.
Every night in the middle of the night?
Yeah, well, about 3 o'clock in the morning every night. I got used to that. You know, my 2-year-old, my 3-year-old does that.
Mm-hmm.
That's not.
Well, you know, they need a diaper change or something. You know.
Nice.
Okay.
But they've been gone for 5 days now. Mm-hmm. I got 5 more days. I ain't ate nothing since they left. And every time I try to eat, I can't eat. But I've been drinking like very heavily.
Yeah, I see.
No kidding.
And I took my Playboy out and jacked up a few times to it. And
hold on, let me write that down. Playboy, yeah, checked off.
I usually have sex with her every night.
Your wife,
but you don't talk to her,
right?
Okay.
How does she know?
We don't communicate.
All right.
She's here. I'm here. The kids are here.
Right.
You know everything. You know, I work and everything.
Well,
you talk, but you don't communicate. Like you say stuff like, "Woman, where's my vittles?" And like, "Hold still" and stuff like that.
Yeah, you know, I'm going to go outside and cut the grass, you know, dinner and all this.
Right, right.
You know, it's basically bull.
Hey, watch the language here, man.
You know, just basically, you know, just it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
My problem is.
Were you a heroin addict one time?
No.
Were you on crack or something?
I don't smoke weed or nothing. I drink beer.
When are they coming back?
On the 22nd.
Uh-huh. And just a few more days. What do you,
five more. I'm halfway there.
Well, the reason you're not sleeping is because of the alcohol. And
really?
You can actually, you need, how much are you drinking an average day now?
Well, since they left, I drink a case or a few more after. Yeah, I buy in a case a day.
See, you stop that, you could have a seizure. So I would suggest you get yourself to a doctor before you give yourself some real serious health problems here.
What kind of beer are you putting down there, Mike?
24 Busch Lights.
And the most important thing for the health of your family...
I smell domestic, you know?
Is that you...
I just smell like a Beck's or a Heineken.
You get your alcoholism treated because that is the most serious threat to your family right now.
Alcoholic, Drew. He only does a case or so a day.
Well, I'm sitting there shaking because I ain't eaten nothing in 4 days.
Yeah, the shakiness, though, is the alcohol withdrawal. Doesn't matter if you're eating or not.
Mike, when you get loaded, don't you want a nice fast food burger, a nice chili burger or something?
Well, Easter Sunday, I cooked up in the oven here bacon. I made me some BLTs.
Why don't you call AA locally?
I made my sandwich up, and I couldn't eat. I took a bite of it, and it just made me sick to my stomach.
Yeah, well, you're drinking a case a day of beer. What the hell are you going to eat?
And you are taking some calories in, even though you're drinking light.
Call local AA. Just look in the phone books, AA. Have someone come get you.
Well... I don't drink like this normally.
I understand, but you're doing it now.
I wish my wife would leave me forever, but then she's gone now.
You ought to write greeting cards, Mike.
I wish it would be forever, but now that you're gone, I miss you.
What it is, I'm sitting here bored. I'm looking at these walls.
I understand.
I talk to my dog. I sit here and talk to my dog.
Yeah, I can see your dog.
My dog looks at me like I'm stupid.
Yeah, well, he may have a point there, you know.
But I ain't got nobody else talking.
All right, Mike, what do you do for a living?
I'm a freight handler.
Freight handler. Are you able to go to work in the morning?
Well, I'm off tomorrow.
Mm-hmm. I see. All right. Well, listen, buddy. You got to get some food in your stomach. And, Drew, seriously, can he wean himself down off of this beer a little bit? I mean, he's doing 24 a day. How about doing a 12-pack tomorrow?
Yeah, but he's still getting himself in big trouble here.
Why? 12-pack?
Yeah, 12-pack and then a 6-pack over, like, you know, 2 days each.
Yeah, this guy's not going AA. How about you do, like, 18 beers tomorrow?
I can do 12. You can drop to 12.
Okay, go down to 12-pack, Mike, and see about getting a few corn dogs in you.
I don't think it's going to work, though. I think he needs to be treated. Detoxed.
Really?
Yep.
Why can't he drop down to 12-pack?
Because he's already shaking. So he's having withdrawal all the time. He's sort of trying to keep up with that.
Mm-hmm.
And when he drops down, that withdrawal is going to come crashing through.
Let's just all close our eyes for 1 second and picture those three youngins.
Uh-huh.
They have like a 2-year-old, a 3-year-old, and a 7-year-old.
It's crying every night.
Let's just close our eyes and picture that life. As a matter of fact, let's leave our eyes open and take a nice big inhale. Let's see if we can put ourselves into a... Mike's cabin or trailer, hole or burrow or den or whatever he lives in, dam. Let's all just, yeah, smell that? Knotty Pine, Marlboros, and Bush Light, little BO sprinkled in, little baby crap.
Some vomit over here.
You guys getting, yeah, you guys getting that?
Little dog pee.
Oh, wait, little dog here. Yeah. Okay. Now, you guys think you got it bad? Nope. You ain't one of Mike's kids.
Where's my bourbon?
All right. We'll take ourselves a little break. Alien Ann Farm is around here somewhere, allegedly excited about doing the show, so we'll see if we can dig those guys up and get them in here after this.
Oh, yeah! Loveline, we'll be right back. Call on the 1-800-LOVE-191.
Hi, this is Matt Stone
and Trey Parker from South Park and Baywatch.
And you're listening to Loveline with Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
Nate, yes, you is. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Alien Ant Farm is our guest tonight. Mike Cosgrove, Ty Zamora, and Dryden Mitchell are all here. And Terry Corso, right?
Yeah, he's here.
He's going to come in here later?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. I got that all worked out. Let's see. Should we hear an Alien Ant Farm song,
yep,
and then we'll come back, and then everyone will go, oh, that's Alien Ant Farm. We like those guys.
Yep. Uh-huh. Or right. they hate us, too, so maybe.
Well, they may do that, too.
But it would be 1-800-HATE-191.
Either way, you'll have a label when you come back.
Okay.
You queued up there, Anderson? Yep. All right. This one's called Movies. Farm, everybody. CD's called Anthology, or as it's written here, Antology. And these guys are going to be on the Warped Tour this summer. Which branch? Which leg you guys
we're
doing?
We're on the whole tour.
Oh, really?
Yeah we're going to
wow, that's good.
For 2 months with no showers. Yeah.
And I decided I'm going to wear New Balance the whole time instead of Vans.
Oh, yeah, that's a slap in the
face.
I think
he's going to run fast, too.
You know, I always... I have my own, you know why, this is why it's torturous to be me or torturesome to be me, however the text is. Whenever I see a concert and I see a guy bouncing all over the place and he's wearing boots out there, I think, man, I'd have some high tops. I'd tape my ankles, too. I'm, you know, jumping off of amps and equipment and crowd surfing
he's got
and
like
diving.
20-hole docks.
Yeah. I mean, right. Cool.
Steel toe. It's 100 degrees outside, and he's wearing a cape with a black leather jacket.
And a Slayer beanie.
To preserve the image,
yeah,
you know.
Slayer beanies are good. Yeah.
Right, and a cod piece, you know. It's like a studded cod piece. Yeah, I'd just be in underpants and high tops. I'd just pretty much treat it like a pickup basketball game. All right. You guys are from Riverside?
Yeah.
Oh, man, that's bad, right?
It's good.
Is it good?
I like it.
You like Riverside?
I dig it.
They got the Mission Inn there.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Ronald Reagan had his honeymoon there. Yeah.
Really?
You know he's jab Nancy in that room.
Jab.
That's gonna run through my masturbatory fantasy.
I wonder, can you booby hump with just one boob?
Oh. Does she just have one now?
Maybe back in the day, like,
I guess you
she
could.
Had both.
I probably. Guess you could if you went in through the shoulder and used the chin as the second boob, like came from the in
he
from
was,
the side.
I heard he was way into ribbing, though.
Yeah. That's good. That's another thing I'll ponder tonight. Matt?
Yeah.
You're 30?
Yep.
What's up?
Got a couple concerns. I'm just wondering if it's because I'm getting older or what. But back in the day, when I'd get an erection, it was pretty damn hard, and I could have sex for a pretty good amount of time.
How long?
And now hard turns into, I mean, I'm married. I have sex a couple, three times a week. Don't have a problem with it, but it's not like it used to be.
Uh-huh.
Back 4 or 5 days ago.
What's the problem?
Or 5 years, I mean.
Right.
What's the problem?
Well, the problem is I'm wondering if it just...
No. What is it? Why is it different than it used to be?
Well, he doesn't know.
Well, it's not hard. So I mean, it's not... It used to be almost so hard that it hurt.
You never get fully erect, or you lose your erection while you're having sex?
Well, I don't get as fully erect.
Are you on medication?
No.
Hey, Drew, what is that with the difference between the it'll do boner and that diving board boner?
You only
get in the morning, it seems. You know, that just that, the one.
Yeah,
where
I don't even get it in the morning.
Makes a cartoon sound.
Yeah.
No, the one you can launch. You can launch a ball of socks off of. You ever do that? Like pull it down, like, hup, there we go, salvo for the hamper. That one where you can actually launch things. And then you got that other one that's just kind of leather.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's like an old old baguette or something.
I mean,
something
left Viagra
out.
Is that where like Viagra would come in? Is that what that helps?
No, it would, but you're only 30 for crying out loud. Do you smoke cigarettes or do a lot of drugs or something?
Nope.
But Drew, what is the difference between that extra burst of blood in there? I mean, that extra pump. You know what I mean? That topped
it's
off
level,
with
level,
blood.
It's levels of arousal.
It could be just in your head.
Even you masturbate what?
It doesn't get as hard.
No, really?
You don't smoke cigarettes?
Nope.
No medicines?
Not drugs.
No medicines. No drugs.
No medicine.
What if you were with a different woman? What do you think?
I don't know. I don't want to think about it.
Well, in the name of science.
Are you overweight? How much do you weigh?
Well, yeah, I guess I am.
How much do you weigh?
I'm 6'1", I weigh 225.
Yeah, well,
I mean, I'm
that's
not
radio
that
talk.
Obese, but I'm not.
5'11", 260, 265. Okay, all right.
But sometimes, you know, the excess fat can cause high levels of circulating estrogen, can change your blood supply to the penis. You know, being overweight and out of shape can impact on all that.
Right. So, Matt, why don't you work on that? It's your only angle.
If I have back problems, would that be something also?
Are you taking any medicine for the back?
No, not medicine, but I just sore back. I wear construction, and so...
You don't take anything for your back?
Nope.
Nothing?
When I injured it, I took, you know, the ibuprofen.
Yeah, true. Drew, it's like we ought to do a daytime TV show called Junkie Hunt. where people call in and they say, no, absolutely, I've never tried. Never? No. Never before? No. Your dad now call it? No. He died when I was eight. Aha, how? Heart attack. Why? I see. You high now? No. No, I've never. Reefer? No. Heroin? No. You just spent a whole day of you.
That'd be nice.
And then eventually you get it down to the fact that they had a drag off a cigarette in 1972. Aha!
Good times.
Aha! And a cap full of Robitussin in 1979, and then you'd claim victory.
Well, you should get a medical evaluation.
Junkie hunt. It'd be
Matt,
good TV.
Matt, you should also get a medical evaluation. Thyroid conditions, other things can impact on this. So there you go.
But, Drew, you're not aroused in the morning when you get that best of all boners. Why, what is that about?
That's about a full bladder.
Mm-hmm.
As much as anything.
Mm-hmm. Interesting.
So what about if you just save your bladder?
The best of all boners.
Maybe he could. That is your best boner that morning. That launched a Sox album boner.
Best of all boners.
Though. That would run after Junkie Hunt.
Best of all boners?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It's good.
All right. I'm done asking questions. Let's move on. Clarissa?
Yeah?
You're 16?
Yeah.
What's up?
I'm, like, really tiny. I'm, like, 5 feet tall, and I'm only, like, a size 2 or 3, you know? But
yeah.
My chest is, like, really big.
Oh.
Like, it's not that big, but it's big on me, you know, like a CRD. And it's just I have these, like, ugly stretch marks.
No, I'm still with you. I'm still with you.
And I was just wondering if there was anything that would make them go away.
The stretch marks?
Yeah, and also, like, I'm a cheerleader and a dancer, too, so, like, the dancing and jumping, I don't want to have really saggy, ugly boobs when I get older. So
I see.
Is there anything that I can do to, like...
Hey, Clarissa?
Uh-huh?
The first thing you can do is turn down your goddamn police scanner or whatever you got going back there.
Police scanner? Oh, the TV?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
Well,
it's a cartoon.
Right.
Warner Brothers cartoon.
What are you watching? Is that Wally Gator? Which one is that?
It's MTV.
Oh, that junk. Please. Shoot that TV like Elvis. Okay. So let me get this straight. 5 foot?
Mm-hmm.
Petite?
Yeah.
Large breasts? Wear a cheerleading outfit and jump up and down all the time.
Basically.
Yeah.
But
yeah. That's
I'm
right.
Really, like, I'm not joking or anything.
I know.
Stretch marks was bothering her, though.
I don't mind the stretch marks. Do you guys mind the stretch marks on a woman?
I'll just close my eyes.
Yeah, that's cool.
Is it not a big deal? You know the thing
isn't
about
like cocoa butter supposed to help that or something?
No,
sounds like
I think
it would.
Cocoa butter maybe like isn't that something you do when your wife's pregnant before she gets the stretch marks?
Yeah.
Nothing else, just a myth?
Yeah,
nothing else.
Oh,
yeah. See, to me, it means when I see the stretch marks, I'm like big jugs can't be far. You know, I'm like an Indian who's going down a trail, you know, sniffing it out. What's this?
It's just horrible when it's the other way around.
Put my ear down to the ground. I listen to the train tracks. Iron horse. Come. Much wampum on a horse.
And, like, the other thing is...
I don't mind that. I like that. Yeah?
Yeah. The other thing is, like, no one in my family, like, really knows where they came from. My mom has a really small chest, and my grandma, like, has implants. Like, they came from nowhere. Like, and so I don't know how much bigger they could possibly get.
Isn't nowhere near Riverside?
She wants to know where her breasts came from.
Yeah,
what about your dad?
Does he
have big breasts?
Hold on. Did you say your grandmother had implants?
Yeah.
How old's your grandma?
Wait, how did that all get by, all four of you?
Because, I mean, in my head, it went breast cancer with implants.
What?
That's where my head went.
Your grandmother has implants.
Mm-hmm.
Why is that?
So she looks beautiful.
How old's your grandmother?
Not that old.
How old?
Maybe 50-something.
Yeah. How long she had them implants?
I think for a while, back when they could still use silicone, so.
Wow, so she got them, like, I don't know, 15 years ago?
Same Maybe even more. I don't...
Wow, we're really... Remember we were talking about time going by quickly? Grandma's got implants now, and ain't no big deal to Clarissa.
Well,
she's like, I'm like, your grandma has implants? Like, yeah.
To look good? It's a big deal.
Hey, retard. Yeah, duh. So she can fill out her bra. Wow. All right. So we know where she got hers. No one knows where you got your boobs.
No. And so, like, I'm really afraid I'm going to be able to...
You know, my family's the same way with my sack. Nobody knows.
That's great.
My dad has a medium sack. My grandfather's a small sack. I have a huge sack.
You're Mr. Elastic.
I don't know where it came from. Yeah, we talk about it every Thanksgiving. I pull my sack out. I put it right in a serving tray, and everyone wants to know where it came from.
It's like you stick it, stuff it in the cornucopia.
Horn of Plenty.
Yeah. Clarissa, you're fine, baby.
Okay.
Just relax.
There's nothing you can do.
Yeah, you're trying to second guess what you're going to be like. There are plenty of things that can be done if you have a problem with this or it starts to affect your back or neck or shoulders.
How old can you be to get them taken away?
Well, I mean, Soleil Moonfry, when she was 16.
How's the shape of the breast now?
Round? I don't know.
Okay. Boy, you're what you call a concrete thinker, aren't
guess
you?
Guess what?
Do they face the floor or the sky?
They're not trapezoidal shaped or oblong.
No.
They're not hexagonal. You're saying they're round breasts.
Yeah.
Interesting. Let me write that one down. Boy, I think she hit her head cheerleading, maybe. Maybe she fell off a pyramid or something.
Maybe one of her boobs hit her in the head a couple times.
But this is that pain in the neck quality, right?
Oh, she must be good looking. Hold on a second.
I'm hot and I want to care.
Clarissa?
Yeah?
You're good looking, right?
Oh, thanks, sweetie.
Are you? I'm asking. You're good looking? Yes?
I guess.
Yeah, you are. So. I know, because you're a little bit of a pain in the ass.
Oh, sorry.
That's all right, baby.
You can't help it.
You make me feel bad. You can't help it. You're good looking.
Oh, well, you know.
Okay.
Bye.
Take care. Now, I know from talking what good-looking girls sound like over the radio, because they answer questions like, your grandma has a breast job? Yeah. Why? To look better. Your breasts, what shape are they in? Round? Yeah, they kind of, good-looking girls can make you feel like an asshole for every question you ask.
For sure.
Except when you're not encumbered by their appearance, they just sound like a pain in the ass.
Yeah, if I was standing in front of her, I'd be apologizing. Yeah. Sorry, that was stupid. That was stupid. You're right. Stupid question.
You're right.
Sorry about the grandma. Stupid. In the breast? Retarded. Borderline retarded. I'm going to kill myself later. Can I have a BJ? Right. Fat chicks don't answer questions that way. They apologize. It's great. All right. Alien Ant Farm is our guest tonight. We'll take ourselves a little break when we come back. Drew, speak to Nancy, who's 16. She likes her gay friend and is thinking about being in a threesome. Is her gay friend a chick? Nancy? Nancy?
Hello?
Is your gay friend a guy or a girl?
It's a guy.
Okay. Hold on a second.
Hello?
Hello.
Hello, Frisco.
Ethel Merman in the house. We'll take ourselves a break. We'll be back.
Hello. Who's this?
This is LoveLine. 1-800-LOVE-191. LoveLine will be right back.
Yep. LoveLine. I'm Adam Carolla. That is Dr. Drew over there. Cypress Hill in here tomorrow night. Is that right, Drew?
Yep.
Yeah. All right. It'll be good to see those guys for the 10th time this month.
Did you let them smoke pot in there?
No. We asked that they step... No, do they smoke pot? They don't smoke pot.
They sure have, I'm sure.
I think Drew Bogarts it all.
Yeah. They get a little nervous when I'm around.
Yeah, Drew has, I don't know if the kids still use these, but Drew's old school. He has the six-shooter that attaches to his bong. It's that six-slot bowl that you twist it around. Well, the one Drew uses is more like a clip. You slide it from left to right. It's like click, 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 click.
Like a machine gun.
Yeah, you know you're smoking a lot of weed when you have to preload six bowls. You know, like you can't take the time in between bowls to load another goddamn bowl.
No, I would have guessed Drew for a converted mini vacuum electric pot.
He did that, but he burnt that out and then
melted it.
And then what he did is he tried to run it off his cigarette lighter. They had an adapter in the car and it fried the electrical system. So he put that away and he went standby with the gas mask ball. That's the other one too.
Look at these guys' schedule. They're in Hollywood, then Mesa, Arizona, then Tinley Park, Illinois, and then London, and then back to Phoenix, Arizona, and Las Vegas, Nevada. I mean,
that would be Alien Ant Farm, by the way.
God.
We tired. We so tired after the schedule like that.
Where? Oh, my God. Yeah. Well, you guys, you're young. You got life in you.
The cocaine really
It helps.
No, I have this fear of saying the wrong city just because we're, like, traveling. Yeah. But it hasn't happened yet.
Right. Well, that's why you can't. You just go, you do what I do, which is I hear... And I pause and I go, you guys like the party! And you never get into trouble that way. You want to use that one?
I'll take it.
You guys. Big, long, noticeable, uncomfortable pause. Look at a couple other bandmates and then go, you guys.
I think you guys is near Riverside, too.
Yeah, Ronald Reagan nailed Nancy and you guys, I think, for their anniversary. Oh, speaking of Nancy. Hey, it's Nancy on the phone. She's 16. What's up?
Hi.
Hey.
Are you still pushing the say no to drugs?
Yeah.
What's going on, Nancy?
Oh, you got the gay male friend.
Yeah.
Who you're turned on by, right?
Yeah, I'm like, I really like him.
Yeah. He's gay, Nancy.
Yeah.
You think he may be bi?
I'm not sure because, like, I don't really talk to him about it anymore.
Mm-hmm. About what?
About him being gay.
Why?
Because, like, I don't know, like, he just doesn't really like to talk about it very much.
Okay. And you want to have a threesome with him and another male?
I'm thinking about it, yeah.
Why? Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I'm really starting to like him, and maybe he'll start liking me if...
No.
I was thinking about a threesome in high school. I was considering that.
That is not how guys work, Nancy. And especially not how gay guys work, but it's not how any guy works.
If it's two guys who are gay, why would you, like, strike out twice there?
Yeah.
But making a guy sleep with you does not make him like you. Okay. No way.
Because maybe I was thinking we could get closer.
No way. No way. That's not how men work. But gay men are gay. You're not going to change him from being gay to heterosexual.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. Brokenhearted and plagued with the HIV. That's how he's going to leave you, Nancy.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So why don't you find yourself a nice straight guy?
Okay. And also, I'd like to say hi to Alien Ant Farm.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi, and I don't know, I don't know if you guys remember me and my friend Seema, we sat on Ty's lap on Saturday.
Wow, lucky Ty.
I remember Seema.
Oh, you don't remember me? You told me you love me more than your mom.
I remember you.
but
I love my mom more than you.
Yeah.
That's not what you said Saturday.
Yeah, well, hey Nancy, are you really offended that he likes you second to his mother?
No.
All right, so you can get over that.
Hey, I have a lesbian friend named Nancy.
That's crazy,
That's pretty funny.
That could be her.
Yeah.
She needs to find herself a nice guy. And, trying to convert a gay guy into loving her because she had sex with him is a horrible, horrible plan.
Bad strategy.
I've tried that multiple, multiple times. It does not work. Rachel?
Hi.
Hey, you're 23.
Yes.
What's up?
My question is, about a year and a half ago, I was diagnosed with osteoporosis.
And why? And were you on prednisone or something when you were younger? Or?
No, I'm bulimic.
Okay.
And I've been bulimic for about 10 years.
Did your ovary shut down or anything like that?
No.
Okay.
I mean, I've never had a regular menstrual cycle, but even prior to the bulimia, I didn't. So. Okay.
Your ovary still function, though?
Yes.
All right.
Yes. And my question is, my doctor had sent me to a bone specialist, and I got a bone scan done and everything, and he thought that I should go on Fosamax.
Right.
On what?
Fosamax.
I'm sorry?
So she was throwing up, or...
She's barfing, yeah.
Most her teen
many
years?
Yeah, now she's got soft decalcification, demineralization of her bones.
Because she didn't get the nutrients she needed? And
basically, that's it. I mean,
are your teeth all funky?
Actually, they're not. They probably should be, but they're not.
Right.
All right. Well, what's the question now? So you're on the Fosamax.
I didn't go on it because I went to the bone specialist. He wrote a letter to my doctor saying that I should go on this. And then she started doing some research, and they basically found out that there haven't been any studies done on women that have not already gone through menopause, and that basically I would be a guinea pig.
Nonsense.
Well, like
we use it on men. We use it on all kinds of osteoporosis now.
But
maybe
her concern was that if it's stored in my bones, if I was to get pregnant, she didn't know if it would do any harm to an unborn fetus.
I think that is nonsense.
All right, so what should she do?
I mean, if you've got a very serious issue here, right?
Right.
You have to find some sort of bone restoring therapy. If you don't want to use you want to use Fosamax, then use calcitonin, use mycalcin, use something, or use other diphosphonates in cycles. But diphosphonates do not circulate in which is what Fosamax is in that class. It doesn't circulate.
True. What are you looking at? What am I going to call you on that? Fosamax is not in that class. That's a calcium carbonate class.
Don't circulate.
I've studied Fosamax for many years.
You need to talk to the bone specialist.
I have double blind tests both Fosamax and Acemax, and I can tell you conclusively that there's a large difference between those two supplements.
Rachel?
Yes.
The bone specialist.
I guess the problem is that
I like that title, Bone Specialist, though. Yeah, that's kind of cool.
That's your bone metabolism specialist.
Send you to the bone specialist, baby. Give me some more.
The studies that she did find that were done.
It's a girl.
That's sick.
And they're unborn.
Look, you talk to the specialist. I guarantee you he's had experience.
The reason I'm calling is because my insurance ran out and I can't go back.
You can call them. You can call her and discuss it on the phone if you have concerns about this. This could potentially become a life-threatening problem for you. It is a very serious issue. And if you don't want to use the Fosamax, you need some form of bone-restoring therapy.
That's
obviously,
right.
No smoking, calcium, vitamin D, and exercise is an important part of this, too.
Or you'll be going to the boneyard, right?
Yes, sir.
Hey, listen, y'all, all you young gals who want to fit into your mini dresses and culottes and whatever the hell you're wearing. They still wearing tube tops, Drew? This is what happens. You vomit. You might as well just throw your skeleton up right out your mouth, right?
Yeah.
Just heave it out a bad cartoon.
That's the easy complication.
It is?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. You ruin yourself. You really will. You'll look good through high school. You won't even look good. You'll be too skinny. We like a little curve on that ass.
Yep.
And then you'll be like, Nancy Reagan.
Yeah.
At age 23.
Girth is good.
That's right.
It's gross.
All right, Alien and Farmers, our guests. We'll take ourselves a little break, and we'll be back with them and you after this.
Hello, who's this?
This is LoveLine.
1-800-LOVE-191. LoveLine will be right back.
The LoveLine. I'm Adam Carolla. That's Dr. Drew over there. Cypress Hill in here tomorrow night. Alien and Farm in here tonight. Anthology is the name of the CD. We're doing a little rotation here, so let me just make sure I got everyone right here. We got Ty and Terry and Dryden in here now,
yep.
Right?
Yes, sir.
Yes. And we'll keep the rotation going. All right, so we take some more calls, get back to the phones.
No, let's just sit here.
No, you want to just sort of ruminate a little?
Yeah.
You guys got a website or anything? Anything you want to plug? Any phone numbers? Anything like that?
You can go on our website. It's alienoutfarm.com.
All right.
With three W's in front of it and a dot.
Oh, yeah.
Good times.
Yeah, good times. All right. You guys got I got to say, we get a lot of bands in here. You guys got a pretty good following of guys out in the parking lot there. That's nice.
Yeah, I was kind of surprised by that. I wasn't expecting
How do those kids know that this is where Loveline is?
Yeah, that's good a good, question. Good, scary question.
Because
those
are not people that have shown up before for anybody else.
No, they aren't the usual autograph hounds.
Yeah.
Yeah, those are hardcore Alien Ant Farm
fans. They
probably
call K-Rock and ask, you know.
Nah, they probably... Oh, yeah. They probably did.
And they just tell them?
Yeah.
Well, you got to understand...
Their infinite wisdom.
You got to... You know, it's a weird thing about security and phone operators and stuff. It's sort of the guy who's lowest on the totem pole is the guy who's answering the phones.
Yeah.
So you can pretty much call and just pick his brain.
Isn't that what you do, though, is answer the call?
Yeah. That's true.
Well, we have found a way to parlay that.
That's a valid point.
We found a way to parlay that phone op job into something on air.
Yeah. That's right. That's right. Different. We stuck it out. That's right. Drew was a van driver just 18 months ago, right, Drew?
It was 3 years ago.
Sorry, buddy. I know. Shawana?
Shauna.
Well, it's spelled in a weird way.
Shawana, you wanna?
All right. What's up there?
Well, I do this really weird thing. Like, I'll sit there for, like, hours and I'll, like, pull my hair. Like, I'll scrape it. And then, like, after that...
How do you scrape your hair?
Huh?
You scrape your hair? How do you scrape it?
I don't know how to explain it. Like, with my fingernail.
Mm-hmm. You pull it, so...
Yeah.
Your scalp or your hair?
Like, my hair.
Mm-hmm. Is it coming out?
Sometimes I pull it out. Sometimes I just...
Could we tell by looking at you? That's what you do?
No, most people can't tell.
Most hair pullers like that have a spot that they pull on.
Well, yeah, I do, and it's like underneath, like...
So you can't... We couldn't see that spot.
Yeah,
but if we pulled your hair up and looked at that spot, we'd see it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, let's not do that.
No.
What's the question?
Well, there's one to it. Like, after that, this is, like, really embarrassing, but, like... I'll, like, go into this thing where, like, I'll masturbate to, like, not, I don't know, it's not, like, a fun thing. It's, like, it hurts, like, to hurt myself. Like, I think of really weird things.
Like what?
Yeah.
Like, people, like, raping me or something.
Does that ever happen to you?
I don't know. I don't really remember.
Do you think maybe that happened to you?
I don't know. And then after that, I cut myself.
Oh, boy.
I see. So everything's going along great, though, right?
You should try branding. I hear it's really good.
Where do you cut yourself?
Like places like where people wouldn't be able to see, like
thighs.
Like, well, no, actually, because I'm a cheerleader and like I can't have people see that.
You have an eating disorder too, huh?
Huh?
Eating disorder also.
I used to.
Yeah.
It kind of relapsed sometimes.
You should start you should start cutting farts instead of yourself.
That'd be a great PSA for you guys to cut. Cut farts, not flesh. Hi, right, we're Alien and Farts. You know, we have a lot of fun on stage, but one thing that's not so funny is cutting. One thing, although, that is very funny is cutting a fart.
Yeah, if you're going to cut something, you know, cut the cheese.
That's right. Yeah, you women, you don't have that love, do you?
No, they can't find love in that. No.
I tell you, I kill myself. That's an empty life.
Without fart humor?
That's a shell of a life.
But then isn't it weird when you find one that does find humor in it, you're kind of weirded out by
Yeah, you're a little suspicious. Let me see. Quick nut check.
Pick her up for like the second date and she farts in your car and she starts cracking up.
Right, and you're thrown off. Like, wait a minute. I got to rethink this whole fart thing. I thought I was in love with it until it came out of you.
Maybe you should stop pulling the hair on your head and pull your leg hairs out and you don't have to worry about shaving anymore.
No.
What is your question exactly for us?
Well, I don't know. Like, I've gone through, like, a lot of therapy, and, like, I've taken different medication, and it just doesn't seem to help.
Mm.
And, like, the medicine I'm on right now worked, like, for a while, but now it doesn't.
What do you want?
Zoloft.
How much?
50.
Maybe need more. Because Zoloft sometimes wears off after a few weeks.
Yeah, it seems like all my medicine I've ever taken. All
right. Well, do you see a psychiatrist, or is it a general doctor prescribing this stuff?
A general doctor, but I've gone to psychiatrists too. I've been in and out of like a bunch of different doctors.
Okay. All right. Well, you got to stay with it. I mean, I know
it's
really
hard because right now we have no money. Because my dad.
Okay. Well, how about you know what you're doing? How about stopping? Do you think you could do that?
I can't with the hair.
Well, not with you saying that.
The hair thing's the hardest.
How about you stop masturbating?
How dare you?
Okay,
I didn't call this show. Why does everything turn to my penis, by the way?
But, Shauna, why don't you go to like a support group for women, something like that, somewhere you can talk and get some support from peers? And
I can't, like, do that, though.
Why?
Because, like, I can't, like, let my parents know really, like, how bad it is.
Why?
Because, like, my mom's stuck on this whole idea that I'm, like...
Perfect.
Yeah.
Right. That's where you got the eating disorder and all mess in the first place.
Yeah, she used to have bulimia.
Interesting.
Huh?
She used to have bulimia?
When I was, like, little, she told me about it. Like, that... She told me about that when I was, like, 2 years old.
Maybe she can relate to it and you should go to her. You never know.
Yeah.
Maybe she could be someone that you could talk to about it and understand.
Yeah, I'm kind of going on off with that. She just gets mad at me if I relapse.
And mom's love is free.
Yeah, why don't you talk to your parents about it or a school counselor? I mean, your friends. You got to work on it. Yeah. There's no easy answer here. And we can't just tell you, do a bunch of stuff, and you tell us, I can't do it.
I know.
You got to do something.
I know.
How about finding Jesus Christ?
I go to church.
Okay, there you go.
I just started again.
Okay, well...
Maybe it was a group with the church.
Yeah.
You need some support. You need a place to talk. You need a group of friends.
I was thinking of farting.
Yeah.
I know she needs help. All right, but let's move on, because I was just thinking about gas. I was in the man show office today in my office with Jimmy, and Bobcat Goldthwait is in there, right? And we're having a 11:30 meeting, and there's about 10, 11 people in this big office. And Jimmy criticizes Bobcat for something, and Bob walks over to his desk and farts on Jimmy. And Jimmy announces, never screw with a guy who can fart on command. And which I'm not so sure Bobcat can do or can't do.
He just made it appear that he could.
He makes it appear. Yeah. And, but it was really great. So Bob's standing in front of everyone after Jimmy says this. And I said, I don't know. I mean, Bob, can you really fart on demand? And before the word demand is finished, a huge fart comes out of him. And I thought, wow, that's touche. That's all that needs to be said, right?
If
there.
If only he could share that talent with the world.
Oh,
he'd be the biggest genius, comedic genius of all time.
I had some respect for him before, but now he's my god. I mean, to be ripping a huge fart when someone is questioning you whether you can fart on demand or not. That's,
right in
that's
your
huge.
Face.
Oh, that was huge. And it was big.
Could you guys work the rest of the day?
I went nuts. No, I went. I had to take a break.
These two here on each of my sides are
really?
pretty close. Like
On demand, huh?
No. It's pay-per-view.
I see.
It's pay-per-view.
If you got something, though, let's hear it. That's all I'm saying.
Okay.
I mean, I don't want to put you guys on the spot.
I can work it up. I'll definitely get
ask
one.
You to play, you know, cold. But I'm saying if something comes up.
My girlfriend's sister, she's in a band, and their old drummer could fart on command. He said he started by, he would do a headstand against the wall and, like, kind of suck air
right.
in there.
Right,
and we have those guys.
And then now he can just do it without having to stand on his head.
It's kind of like a queef, you know, girls do that.
Right. Right.
How did that go again?
Sure, the vagina didn't fall asleep in its story. Adrian?
Hey.
Hey, you're 16. What's up?
Yep. I was wondering about for the summertime coming up, like, you know, for if you shave your chest, does it actually come back, like, darker and thicker?
No.
No?
I don't think anything comes back darker
and thicker.
It comes
back the same.
Yeah. Why should it?
Yeah. Hey, Alien Infarm.
Yes. What up?
How you doing? I saw you with Orgy at the House of Blues in Chicago. You guys were amazing.
Wow. Thank you very much.
Did you guys ever go Granite?
Yeah, I think we did. I think that's around 15 records, and we're at, like,
paper now. Yeah. I think we're at 17 or 18 now.
Yeah. Good going, guys. Love you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, guys. Bye.
Thanks, Aiden. Hey, how was Orgy? I like those guys.
They're really nice fellas. They're all wound up. They're really, like, high-strung.
Yeah.
Damn. It's fun to be around.
They're awesome.
They put on a great show too. They're a great
band. Yeah, yeah. I've never seen them live actually, but we've had them on the show.
It's a good show. They're great live.
Zach.
Yes.
You're 21.
Yes.
What's up?
Well, my main problem is my girlfriend is real well endowed. Let's just say.
Your girlfriend has a large penis,
big vagina,
the crotch area.
No, she's got rather large breasts.
Oh,
good, yes. We're listening.
And I'm not. So it's, you know, we start getting, you know, we live together and we, you know, we're naked or whatever, and it's like.
Yeah.
She's quite a turn on. I feel like I'm not, you know what I mean?
Your breasts are small.
Right?
No.
We're confused. You have a small penis and she has large breasts.
Yes.
So what?
Okay, fine.
So what?
That's good for you.
So it's like the opposite. When you get a Dodger dog and the buns are little, like she's got the big boobs and you got the cocktail weenie.
Do you somehow think that women are turned on by the size of a penis the way some men are turned on by the size of breasts?
Aren't women like more like...
Zach, do you believe that?
No, not necessarily at all.
No, that's right. So what's the problem here?
It's more I feel like I guess I don't satisfy her the way she does me.
Does she tell you that?
No.
So where is this all coming from?
It's growing. How big is your penis?
That's between me and myself.
Well, I see.
Or me and my girlfriend, I guess, rather.
Roughly, give us an estimate.
Probably about 5 inches.
So that's...
That's not too bad.
That's normal.
Yeah, that's all right.
That's normal. So what is it about your life that has become a symbol for an ad?
I really want to talk to Zach.
Zach, are you not working?
What's that?
Are you not working?
Am I not working? No, I work.
Okay. Listen.
Women are vocal, not
I
visual.
Can't,
anyways,
what kind of crazy? I can't spend a night with Zach. Are you working, huh? Are you working? Am I working? It's too much.
Thanks to him.
He's got a small penis, fine.
He doesn't have a small penis. He doesn't feel adequate as a person, and the penis has become a symbol for that.
Yes. Yeah, that's just all. Go down on her more. You compensate with your mouth.
Yeah, but she hasn't complained about anything. She may be perfectly happy. Listen, a lot of women like small as opposed to big.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Nice. I got to find some of them.
You know,
they're around? Yeah.
You know the Sam Phillips? I do that.
Yeah, the blonde you do that TV show
Mars
with?
Penis?
What
small.
About her?
Small.
Likes a small penis?
Small.
She's just saying that to make her vagina accessible to the common man.
No, no. No.
Her vagina's a good politician.
No?
No? All right. She likes small penis. Yeah. But you know why? A small penis is nice. It's like hiring a handicapped guy. They work harder. But they compensate.
You know, they show up earlier. Hey, big hurts. Big hurts. That's it. It's ouch. Uncomfortable.
Really? You okay?
Well, big
hurts. Oh, you're talking about women.
It hurts me.
I see.
Small hurts, too.
All right. Sima? Sima?
Simmer down now.
Simmer down now? S-I-M-A?
Anyone?
All right. 16? Got it.
Sleeping? I heard her.
Really?
Stalker.
No, chicks don't snore, though.
Yeah, no. Yes.
Maybe it's the queef.
Put her back on.
No, huh?
Matt?
Hey, guys. What's up?
Hey. You're 21. What's your question?
Man, I can't believe I'm talking to Dr. Drew and the great Spudini.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. I need to set this up with a quick story, so please bear with me. I'm in a fraternity. About 3 weeks ago, we had a party, big party, lots of people there. Three girls show up at the door, look pretty young. I was guessing probably about 18. They come in. One of them takes off right away and starts dancing with a bunch of different guys. Ends up dancing with a friend of mine. My girlfriend and I are talking to the two other girls, just making small talk, And I said something to him like, so you guys are freshmen, and they kind of giggled a little bit, and they're like, yeah, we're freshmen, and I was like, what's so funny? After prepping them for a while, found out that they're actually freshmen in high school. They were both about 15 years old, and their friend was also 15 years old. Later on, their friend hooked up with my friend, who's also 21, the same age I am, in the fraternity.
Yeah.
And so they hook up and disappear. And for the last couple of weeks, she's been coming over to our place and spending the night pretty regularly. I talked to him about it. I was like, you know, she's 15, right? And he said, yeah, I didn't seem too concerned about it. I said, you know, this is statutory rape. We could get into big trouble if anybody found out. It's not good for her. He didn't seem to really care. And my question is really, you know, how I should proceed with this, if at all. I could probably, you know, I could just leave enough alone and say it's not really, you know, my problem or it's none of my business. Or I could talk to, you know, the executive council of my fraternity.
You got
to
do that.
How about the evil dean?
No.
Should you get him involved?
There's got to be a due process within your fraternity. You got to do that, or you will be a part of this when it comes down.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah.
And not only that, it's the right thing to break this up in some way.
Yeah, I mean, as serious as the fraternities are taking this kind of thing nowadays, it's something he could potentially get kicked out for.
Yeah.
But I mean, and probably with good reason. I hate to do this kind of thing to.
Yeah, talk to your head guy. I'm sure he'll pull you aside and say, "Listen, now we here at Chi Data Rape take this kind of thing very seriously."
Maybe the dean will give her a whirl.
Yeah. Maybe they'll look up. You never know. No, I mean,
talk to your fraternity guy. I don't know. Drew, were you in a fraternity?
Not really.
What do you mean, not really? Not really.
I was.
That means you were in one.
No, I took a semester off in college. I came back and lived in a fraternity, but didn't go through the whole.
What the hell does that mean?
Yeah, it was kind of weird.
No beer bongs?
Oh, there was.
He did a beer bong.
Did you do a beer bong?
That's where he got a six-shooter. Sure, His bong six shooter.
There was a lot of pots being smoked.
Really? Oh, yeah. You didn't condone that at all. And what, wait a minute. You took a semester off of college?
Yeah.
For what? What'd you do?
Nothing.
Nothing? Didn't your dad spaz out?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah, good times.
So you did what? You worked?
You
got
worked,
laid?
Yeah. No.
Yeah?
No.
No? You got laid?
No.
Yeah?
No.
Okay. And then you went, and then you joined a fraternity?
No, I didn't join. It's sort of where sophomores lived so I needed to find a place to live when I got back.
Where? Where was this?
In Amherst.
Really?
Yeah.
And you lived in a fraternity house?
Yeah.
Crazy, man. All right. Brother Drew,
everyone. Any 15-year-olds?
No.
No, no. Some 14 or 13.
It's cool. It's legal in some states, though.
Back then, it was game on. Lisa?
Hi.
You're 35?
Yes.
What's up?
I'm 35, married 17 and a half years.
All right.
March 31st was our anniversary.
All right, well, send you out a windbreaker.
It was at camp. My question is, how do I tell him, you know, I'm done?
You're done with the relationship? Yes?
That's how I feel.
Okay.
First send the windbreaker back to Adam.
Right, I'm going to need that back.
Why are you done?
Why am I done?
Oh, Lisa, are you loaded, Lisa, or what's going on?
Yeah, a little bit, but...
Yeah.
A little bit. Yeah.
About 350.
Hey, Lisa?
Find the junkie.
Yeah.
I know this seems like a normal pace for you because you're loaded, but it's super, super slow. It's like Quaalude slow for us.
Do some speed and call back.
So we need you to pick it up just a little bit. All right. Okay.
Way beyond Quaaludes. That was like in the 70s.
Okay, baby. So you have kids?
I have three.
What are we doing now, heroin or Xanax? Or what are you doing beyond Quaaludes?
Oh, come on. I'm serious here.
All right. No, wait a second.
Whoop-a-doo.
What drugs are you doing?
Hello?
Hi.
What drugs are you doing?
I'm serious here.
We're serious, too.
How do I do this?
What drugs are you doing?
How do I tell him?
What drugs are you... We can't discuss that until we figure out what state you're in. What drugs are you doing?
I don't do drugs. Just Bacardi rum.
Just alcohol.
Just alcohol.
Is he an alcoholic, too?
Yes.
Why do you want to leave him?
He drinks all of our booze.
Getting into your stash, huh?
Why do you want to leave?
I don't want to leave.
All right, so why do you want to tell him you're done if you don't want to leave?
Because I'm tired of babysitting his ass.
Why don't you both do something about your alcoholism? Or why don't you do something first and set a little bit of an example and see if maybe he doesn't follow you into some sort of recovery?
Hey,
he's both loaded, ain't going nowhere, no matter what. And you're just going to go from one miserable relationship into another.
And I've got to be the strong one. I've been the strong one for 7 years.
Man, don't be strong. Stop being strong. Just go.
It's
go.
Like you said it. That's it.
No, stop being strong. Just sit down.
Do it first. I've got to do it first.
That's right.
I'm the strong one. I'm always the strong one.
Hey, mama.
And you know what? I'm tired of being the strong one.
Yeah, good. Stop having so many goddamn kids then, you screwball.
I don't have a bunch of kids, you screw ass.
You said you had three kids.
You just like being mean.
I do not. Well, okay. All right. You got me on that part. Don't you?
Like being mean because you think it makes you sound cool.
Don't you have three kids?
God, you sound like my husband.
Do you have three kids?
He is
or
cool.
Not?
He's Adam Cool Rolla.
That's right.
The great Spudina.
The kids all love me.
Do you have three kids?
We have three children.
Okay.
16, 15, and 8.
How are they doing?
They're fine.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. They have alcoholic parents.
Yeah.
Okay, so...
At least on their behalf, why don't you sober up? Don't worry about being strong. Just sit down in a meeting and follow some direction.
Okay.
And get yourself cleaned up. Worry about making yourself healthy on behalf of your kids. Don't worry about being strong for your husband. He'll either follow suit or he won't. And if he doesn't, then that's it. Then you're done. But right now you're loaded all the time. You don't know what the hell you want. You're depressed, no doubt. Start taking care of yourself a little bit, then make some decisions. But in the meantime, don't focus on anything else than trying to help yourself.
All right, Lisa?
Oh, exactly. Thank you.
Get sober for your kids, please. All right. Take care of yourself.
Bye, hon.
All right.
Bye.
Good times, baby. Drew had to punch that mic. He felt so strongly about it. Drew, to be fair to you and your left hand, you have not punched a mic more than 8 times a week.
And hour and a half into the show.
Yeah, Drew usually punches the mic very early on in the show. What is that mic? Is that like a Wonder Woman's jet? All right, can you see this? Is it an invisible mic?
Yeah.
All right. That whole, I don't know why, but that invisible jet thing didn't seem like a great angle. It's just got a plane no one knows is in the air. Oh, yeah, that's going to work.
But you could see her.
You could see her ass sitting in it, which is even more distracting.
See a girl in, like, red, white, and blue tights flying through the air in sit-down position.
Yeah, see the outline of the plane.
Yeah, there's nothing real stealthy about that. Hey, look at that chick up there dressed like the American flag. What the hell? How's she getting around? She got a bottle rocket up her ass? What the hell? That's what I like about the cartoon. Stuff that's invisible.
As an outline.
Still has an outline. Yeah, so you know. All right, Alien Ant Farm is our guest tonight. We'll take ourselves a little break, then we'll be back.
Hello, this is your radio. LoveLine will be right back.
LoveLine. I like this riff. What is this band again? American Hi-Fi? Yeah. Kind of like a good air drumming song. Reminds me of Thin Lizzy. I like popular bands like that.
Afros and all.
Alien Ant Farm is our guest tonight. We're back with the original lineup. Mike Tyne, Dryden. And when we left off, we were, at least I was thinking about talking to Christina.
Yeah, it's me.
What's up?
I just was calling just to tell you in Ant Farm, like, how much I love you guys. You guys are, like, so great. I saw you guys on Saturday at Bryan Tire Records. Oh, my gosh. You guys know how to put on the show, and you guys are just so nice when I met you guys, and you guys signed my autograph and everything.
Thank you.
We signed your autograph?
Mm-hmm. I mean, you signed my picture, your picture, whatever. I'm sorry, I'm so nervous.
Did Dryden say he liked you more than his mom?
No.
Yeah, no, that's like, his line, normally.
No, it's because my friend had her picture ripped in half, and he was all like, what part of my body do I sign? So it's funny.
Unacceptable.
It's good PR for the band.
Okay,
you're 15, right?
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, well, I just want to let you guys know I'm so happy for you guys. And I saw you guys at the Glass House. I was there when you guys weren't so big, and I'm so proud of you guys. And you guys inspire me.
We're still the same size. I'm about 160.
No, you guys are like, I'm so proud of you guys, and I can't believe you guys. You guys are like so great.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hey, I love you, Dryden, Ty, Terry, Mike. I love you guys all.
Bye, Christina.
Okay, bye.
Te amo también.
All right, okay. Get to sleep, baby.
Okay, bye.
You're 15.
All right. She's from El Monte. That means the Monte, right? Yeah? Yeah. Let's speak that Spanish. Liz?
Yes?
You're 26.
Yes, I'm 26.
What's up?
That's the first time that I call. Well, I have a question. Last Tuesday, I took the morning after pill.
Mm-hmm.
And because my boyfriend and I use protection, use a condom, but it ripped.
Mm-hmm.
And the next day, I called a clinic, and I took the pill. They told me that the only side effects that it could have would be...
Nausea.
Nausea, that I would throw up.
Mm-hmm.
But pretty much it. And they told me that it would take it within 24 hours. It would be more effective.
Yes.
So I did. But, like, the week before that, I had barely had my period. And since Tuesday is when I took the pill, and I started bleeding.
Last Tuesday.
Yeah, Tuesday I took the pill, and I started bleeding, like, Wednesday afternoon or Thursday. And I called the doctor to see if that was normal, and that guy was just a jerk. He told me that pretty much that it was that I could be bleeding like that for months or even for a year. And I told him, is that normal? And he goes, well, nothing is normal. And I'm kind of afraid. I don't know if that is normal or...
It is a potential side effect of that pill.
For months or year?
No, not for months or year. No. Uh-huh.
Nothing is normal.
No, it'll go about a week or so like that.
What kind of bizarre sort of doctor is that? There's a guy high on mushrooms? The hell is that?
All right, but listen, the one concern I would have is that a tubal pregnancy can... start out with heavy bleeding, and then you get pelvic pain after that.
So I think I was a tube baby.
No doubt. But if you get any pain down there, make sure you have somebody look at it. Because
I did, and one of the other things that they told me that that I could, if I would feel like pain in my leg, and I did experience all that, but I think it was just my head was playing games with me because I was already worried.
It's bad pain. I mean, having a little abnormal bleeding would not be a big deal.
Yeah, boy, I am so glad I don't have a vagina. What a handful. I couldn't maintain one. I got to tell you, I'd be better off just keeping a llama in my house than having a vagina. I really would. I couldn't keep after it. I couldn't keep it up. It'd be ruined. For about 5 years, be using it like an ashtray.
I'd be no good anymore. Oh, my God. Dude,
I'd be like a rock star with a Lamborghini Countach or something, like McDonald's wrappers on the dash and stuff.
But
I'd ruin my vagina. No upkeep.
You would never take tampons out. You just keep putting new ones in.
Now, you know what I'd do, too, is I'd run out of tampons. I'd start stuffing everything up there.
Yeah.
I'd start bawling. I'd be pulling the cotton out of the vitamin things and stuffing them up there. I'd start reusing tampons. It's fine. I rinsed it with some beer.
Flip
the tampon. I'd turn the tampon inside out and stick it back up there. So what if the string went in first? Who knows what goes on in the old vagina, the old vagina, the old
yeah,
vagina.
Yeah, I'd be a mess.
Yeah.
I'd run out of, I'd be using like old t-shirts for maxi pads, and it wouldn't work out for me at all. Larry?
Yeah.
I can barely keep up with my penis. Hey. I need roller skates to keep up with it. Larry?
I just want to see what you guys think about something I've been, like, going over in my mind.
I see.
I've been divorced about 11 years.
Uh-huh.
And I had a girlfriend, but that was about 5 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm 50 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, a long time ago, I used to think that, you know, having sex with animals was, like, a bad thing.
Well, that's what our parents thought, too.
But, you know, I have this female dog.
Right.
And it's a female. It's not a male.
Yeah. There's nothing wrong with
it's
that.
It's a bitch.
Right.
Well, every once in a while, I put on a rubber and I have sex with her.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't see anything wrong with that.
Use a condom.
Yeah. And, like, right. She don't mind, and I keep myself out of trouble and stuff.
Yeah. What kind of dog is it?
It's, it weighs about 75 pounds. She's a half Australian sheepdog and a chow.
I see. Chow. Watch out. They could come back, take a nut off.
Do you still do it when she's on her period?
She doesn't have a period. She's 6.
Oh, I see. Smart.
That's smart.
Smart move,
time.
Yeah.
That's a fake call, huh?
I don't know. I'd like to believe him.
Well, she truly is man's best friend.
Does she have a purple tongue?
No, it's kind of got black on it.
I see. Yeah.
But, you know, the thing is, society says, you know, that's a wrong thing, but I don't see nothing wrong with it.
Does her tail ever whip you in the face?
No, she's got a little tail.
Let me tell you something. Society told Harry Tubman not to go to the front of the bus. Wait a minute. That was not to start the Underground Railroad and Rosa Parks not to go. One of those black chicks not to move around so much. But you know what? Rosa Parks went to the front of the bus, and society's a better place because of it.
I think people perceive that as, at minimum, first of all, it triggers all kinds of weird fantasies of people. But I mean, that you're capable of other things that might not be so pleasant.
Yeah, you show me a guy who's banging his dog, and I'll show you a guy who could get hold of a kid or bomb a 7-Eleven.
No, I would never do that.
And it turns out they don't. If you really study the people,
Difference between a little kid and a dog.
Now, secondly, you're exploiting something that is sort of defenseless and can't really.
Yeah, but she likes it.
Yeah?
Well, I know,
we get into this argument all the time.
Isn't that better than, like, going out, you know, and picking up some crack hole?
No.
It isn't?
For the dog or for you?
Well, for me.
Oh, I see, yeah. Not for the dog. Yeah, it's probably better than you. Does it have to be the dog or the crack hole? There's nothing in between?
Well, the dog is a lot less trouble.
I understand.
Plus, I feed her and stuff.
Sure. Yeah.
It's a cheap date. I mean, some Alpo.
Have another kielbasa in your ass. Yeah. All right.
Is there something wrong with me, or is that?
Well,
I tried to reason it out,
and
I'm not hurting anybody, and she don't mind. And
listen,
what's her name?
Huh?
What's the dog's name?
Barbara? No, Baba.
Baba.
Yeah.
Is it like an Indian dog?
Well, that's short for a full name.
What is that?
A Baba Booey.
Stupid.
Oh, it's a Howard Stern thing.
Yeah.
All right. But that was good there, Larry.
Yeah, well done.
Thank you.
I went along with that. I really did.
Okay.
I like that.
Yeah, well, it was kind of like on the cuff.
Yeah, no, I know. You're flying by the seat of your pants.
Right.
But you rolled with it pretty good.
Go hump your dog. Kept the character.
Hey, man, I don't have sex with my dog.
Go hump your dog.
No, okay, he's right. He doesn't. But I still enjoyed that call. I don't mind a bogus call every once in a while. And, you know, to me, there's no real bogus calls on this show because somewhere there's someone listening to the show who is actually raping their dog.
They're on to me.
All right, you want to take another call?
Or how about
a song? I want to hear a song from Alien and Farm?
Yeah.
Yeah. Does that mean you got to pee, Drew?
No.
Or
what's I just don't know when the hell we're going to play if we do it now.
All right. Well, let's hear something from Alien Ant Farm. This one is called Courage.
Hey, this is Tyra.
Oh,
that's Tyra Banks.
I tried not to.
everyone. Anthology is the name of the CD. It is currently out. So you may get that whenever you like if you haven't already gotten it yet. We will take a break. When we come back, we'll speak to Sandy, who's 19, wants to know if you can get pregnant from anal sex. This is one of my favorite. This is why I stay with this job. People say to me, they really do. They go, listen, you got another gig. You're doing stuff. You ain't getting rich off of this thing. It's every night. What the hell are you wasting your life over at that studio for? But it's this. It's the can I get pregnant from being cornhole tall that keeps me coming back every single night.
It's the drip.
That's right. We'll be back.
Hi, this is Tori Amos, and you're listening to Loveline with Adam Carolla and Dr. True.
Mike, Terry, and Ty are all here from Alien Ant Farm. Jeez, yeah, we haven't had Tori Amos in here in a while, have we, Drew?
Did she ever come on the radio? She was on TV a couple years ago.
She's been on the radio a few
times.
About
the same time 2 years ago?
I don't know. She had a baby, Ann said.
3 years ago?
She gave birth to that pig she was nursing and that whatever that album was. What was that?
Oh, man.
Yeah. All right. So she had a kid. Boys for Pele, yeah. Remember that? You ever see that album cover? She's like nursing a pig.
Nice.
Yeah.
Aren't you anxious to get on to your favorite call here?
Huh? Oh, yeah, my favorite call. That's right.
Forgot, firstly.
Forgot about that. I got so... I was just picturing Tori Amos with that pig. Sandy?
Hello.
Hello.
How you doing?
Hello.
What's going on?
Can you hear me?
We got you. What's up? What's up?
Question.
Yes.
Well, I asked not to be on the air, but I guess that's okay now.
All right.
I need to know, can you get pregnant from having anal sex?
How do you figure that would work?
Excuse me?
And what would the kid look like? That's my question. We'd have like a corn stuck to him.
Howdy ho.
Little brown booty baby.
How would that happen, you figure?
I don't know. Well, I just want to be cautious.
That'd kind of like be like really dropping the kids off, huh?
Let's try to figure this out. Now, what about oral sex? You figure that you could get pregnant that way?
Well, of course not.
All right. And, how about nasally? No?
I don't know about you, but I'm not into nasal.
Oh, you're not? Well, you haven't tried it then, because everyone who's tried it is into it. Right, Drew?
Are you using this as a birth control? Is that your idea?
No.
You're not.
Anal sex?
We use protection.
I see.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So why don't you use that same protection during this act?
Well, because I figured it's different.
I see. So you don't use the condom during the anal sex?
No.
That'd be a good time to use one.
Yeah.
You think so?
Yeah.
More likely to bleed.
Yeah, that's the time to break out that condom is when something's in your ass.
Because that's when you can get pregnant.
Right. Now, Sandy, you can't get pregnant from that.
You cannot.
Well, I guess she's trying to make the case that something could drip down or something, you know what I mean?
Yeah, maybe if you did it in a wind tunnel or something.
No, so you cannot get pregnant from
semen. We don't see how.
Where's his semen going?
Well,
I mean,
not in the uterus.
In the back.
Right. So eventually, yeah.
Now, I have a question then.
Right.
I need to talk to Dr. Drew about this.
I see. Right. If the world is flat around, or what is it?
No, okay. For some reason, well, I haven't been doing this for a while, but just lately, well, it obviously hurts a lot, but since we've been doing it, every morning, I bleed a lot.
Yeah. Rectal bleeding.
I'm sorry, yes.
Yeah.
Why is that?
Well, you're being raped in the anus with a large instrument. And okay. That can cause bleeding.
That is not good, Sandy.
Trianal rape, yes.
First of all, make sure you take your iron supplements, but second, you have to see a doctor about this.
Really?
Absolutely. Thirdly, it's a great way to get sexually transmitted diseases, being the receptive partner in anal intercourse.
And fourthly, why are you doing it if you're bleeding out of your ass in the morning? I mean, how? What's up with your self-esteem?
Most guys can't get their girl to do it like that.
And it hurts badly.
Yeah.
Well, Well, I thought it was because it was something new that, you know.
No, listen. Listen, you keep doing it, though, right?
Just a few times. Just like three times we've done it.
Okay, but one is enough if you're bleeding out of your ass, right?
Well, yes.
All right. So, look, you were a trooper. You tried. You understand? He can't fault you for that.
And you got a good sign to stop.
Would she be the pooper trooper?
Yeah. You gave it the old college try, and it just didn't work out for you. That's all right. You can't win every anal fight. So my grandfather told me that many years ago. Son, you're going to lose some battles of the anus.
F-poop.
F-poop. You hold your chin up, and you hold it up high. Yeah. You guys watch pornography?
Yes, very much so.
Yeah. And, you know, the tri-anal rape reminded me of when I was talking to, I think it was Amber Lynn. It was either Ginger Lynn or Amber Lynn, but I think it was Amber Lynn. And you old school porn guys will know who that is. And she was I said, listen, that dude, there's a dude named John Leslie, I think the guy's name was. Oh, man. One of those old guys. I swear to what the hell? John Leslie, we'll say the guy's name is. He used to keep his eyes closed. He seemed like he hated women. What the hell is this guy's name? It's going to drive me nuts. All right, anyway. I said, this guy seemed a little tough on women. Didn't seem like he liked them very much. Every movie I saw him in, he was slapping the chick on the ass and grabbing her by the hair. And he was really rough with them. And she was like, no, no. She got kind of defensive. He was a good guy. Yeah, I mean, you had to get to know the guy. I mean, one time he did dry anal rape on me. But other than that, he was a pretty decent guy.
Except for the dry anal rape.
Yeah, and I thought, wow, that's what I love about porn stars.
Did he stick his fist in her mouth?
Yeah, dry anal rape. And,
aside from that, he's a perfect gentleman.
That's right. That's right. Sir Walter Raleigh, beside the dry anal rape. And I thought, well, you got to love that attitude. Not going to hold it against him. All right. Tyler?
Yeah.
You're 21. What's up?
How you doing, Adam?
Good.
I got a question for Dr. Drew.
Yeah.
I had, I kissed a girl on a Friday, and on Sunday, I had a lump on my lip, and about 2 days later, I had the entire roof of my mouth was covered with blisters and sores.
Yeah, interesting.
And then under my tongue, about 2 days later after that.
You weren't taking any medication during this time?
Negative.
Okay.
No, I was not. I went to the doctor.
It's herpes.
And, they said, we don't know what it is.
Well, it's herpes.
Well, yeah. I found that out about a week and a half after the whole thing started out.
All right.
My question to you is, how soon, like, I kissed her and then 2 days later I had a lump on my lip. Is it 100% sure that she gave it to me?
No.
Or can it go into regression for months on end?
It's not 100% sure. It can be up to 2 weeks after exposure.
Okay, and I wasn't with anybody for like 3 months before her.
You probably figure it's her, right?
Yeah,
I figure it's her. But
I think that's reasonable.
Lawsuit.
Does she have anything?
Unless he was kissing any car batteries.
Does she have anything you could see?
No, she didn't. She didn't have anything that was visual that I could see.
You're talking about you just kissed her in the mouth, right?
Yes.
So you're going out with her?
Oh, no.
No, that's it?
I was drunk.
Yeah. All right, buddy.
Good times.
Yeah, good times. All right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Real good times.
We'll take a break. We'll be back. All right. Well, there it is. Another episode of Loveline, deeply in the ground. I want to thank Alien Ant Farm for coming out here. You guys were great.
Thank you.
We appreciate you coming by. And Anthology is the name of the CD. www.alienandfarm.com. There you go. If you want more information about the CD or touring or any of that good stuff, look for them on the Warped Tour this summer.
We have a link to www.dryanalrape.com as well.
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's going to be a very hot site. So, Cypress Hill tomorrow night. Until next time, it's Adam Carolla for Dr. Drew saying mahalo.
I don't have a bunch of kids, you screw ass.
This has been Loveline. The opinions expressed on this show are not necessarily those of the staff, management, sponsors, or this station. The producer for Loveline is Ann Wilkins Engel. Loveline is a presentation of Westwood One Entertainment.